to represent this data in the form of graph, we will draw here two lines, one along the x-axis, one horizontal line, which is called x-axis, another vertical line called y-axis. At represent marks along x-axis and number of students along y-axis. So here we will use two scale. In bar graph we have used only one scale because in bar graph numbers were only on the y-axis. But here the numbers are on x-axis and also on the y-axis. So we will use here two scales. Here scale used along x-axis, this is one unit. So along x-axis, one unit is equal to 10 marks. One 10 marks, then 10 marks another, then 10 marks. And along y-axis, scale used, one unit is equal to one student. Clear? So from the data, 10 to 20, one student. 10 to 20, one student. 20 to 30, three student. 20 to 30, continuous, 10 to 20, then no gap, 20 to 30. 20 to 30, three students. Then 30 to 40, again three students. Three students. 40 to 50, four students. Then four parallel to this, up to here. Four students. 50 to 60, seven students. So seven here, this one. Seven student. 60 to 70, again seven. So seven student. 70 to 85, five is here, parallel to this. So five student. There are bars, but no gap between the bars because we are having continuous data, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, no gap between the bar. And height of these bars represent the frequency, 1, then 3, 3, 4, 7, 7, and 5. This type of graph where numbers on both the axes and no gap between the bar is called histogram. So when we have raw data, first we will organize that data, divide into groups, continuous class group, and for that continuous data we will represent it by the histogram. Clear?